I have to say one thing, because this is like lurking somewhere. Yeah,
bad
I have
conscience.
A bad conscience about like going against my natural flow somehow, and then doing stuff that is kind of already, I've so many times I've seen that this is not beneficial for me. This only does harm for me, and still I somehow go for it.
Listen, let me tell you something.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
All of you, forget about it. Forget about it. You are remembering these things, and so you bring them into a sort of a significance about them. It's not important.
Thank you.
Yes. Why you want to? Okay, you did something wrong. Why you have to remember? You did something good. Why you have to remember?
Because I believe in this thought that maybe this is the one that is causing my present state.
Yes, and it is. Your belief that something is causing the presence, you believe it into existence. Forget about it. Forget about everything.
But then I think that...
Now you're procrastinating. Forget about it.
That's what I do.
Yes, forget about it.
At the moment.
Forget about it. It's not a joke. Forget about it. I said earlier, it's not that you think that is the problem. The problem is that you keep remembering that you think. And then you're telling stories about thinking. Yeah, I used to be thinking like, who wants to know? The thought is past, it's finished. Why resurrect it? In fact, your natural being, I often refer to it like writing on water. You cannot read it. You cannot read it. 5 seconds later, there are no pages to turn, there's no ink. The consciousness is fresh like this. You are fresh like this. You are fresh, you are freshness itself. But you have cultivated staleness because you know what? You want to know how to live, but you are life. Does life need lessons on how to live? This is all the mind, you see. And this is what makes you clumsy. You hear the word. Yeah, clumsy. Meaning, what is natural, you're trying to practice for what is already natural. You're trying to practice to what is already natural. You're putting so much effort what is already effortless. And all that's missing, if anything, is just this recognition. That's all. What stands in the way of this recognition? I don't wish one of you to leave this place without this understanding. Because everyone around you will benefit from your understanding. Even without you trying to help anyone. How can you help anybody to be free if you're not free? And it's not difficult. What I'm pointing to is not difficult. It's not even easy. It's not even easy, because easy would imply there's certain effort to it. Then it's not effortless. I'm pointing to what is effortless. If effort is to be made, it's not by that. It is by the conditioned mind that has to initially make some effort to stop going to the graveyard. Stop going to the graveyard. You have to cultivate this freshness. Stop going, identifying, telling the story, dead story, ghost story. And gradually, this mind, because what is it that becomes awakened and enlightened? Is only the mind, not the self. The self is eternally awake. The pure being already is perfect. So what is it that must become perfect? What is it that must wake up? It's only the mind. The sattvic mind must wake up. The thought is past, it's finished. Why resurrect it?